And love is a sin and then vengeance is a remedy. What is love? There's no darkness. A letter from the heart to be read on the face. Love is like rain on two and fall. But when it rains, it pours. To me, I love to pour. If love is a sin and then being a newcomer, COVID year, and winning the championship, I mean, we can go through it all. We can go through the challenges we faced with not knowing if we was gonna have a season when I first came. Not even having an assistant coach, only having one coach. If we do play a game, how many people can play? Do we gotta wear a mask? This and that, this and that. But I think through it all that, I mean, it worked out for us. The best time of my life.
Seconds. Up the floor comes Bryce and Johnson. Johnson up the sideline. Long three. Got it! He counts!
Old people say I'm from over yonder. I be floating on the track like Muhammad Ali. My words pierce through your heart and sting like a bee. Don't feel me, it's 50. I'm pretty like Floyd. Life trying to break me, but it fail. Wise man told me God is in the air. So just inhale. Who the hell would have thought that boy would turn to a boy? Man, I'm feeling heroic. Feeling his storm. All that pain was worth it and live the rest of my life as a champion. And I know I deserve it. I would have cried if I were the
up the floor, down low to Williams. Williams goes up and puts it in. James pulls up for three, and he got it. Wiley, top of the key. Wiley drives to the free throw line, finds Zesic in the corner for three. That one's good. Has it stolen by Walker. Walker, fast break, puts the layup up and in. 60-29.
So far, it's just been a struggle trying to put it all together and at the same time have the confidence to go and stop the next team that already has together.
That one intercepted by Jackson Parks. He's going the other way. Up and off the glass for two. Tie ball game at 60. And he'll drive off the glass with the left hand and good. Court right, he'll drive right hand off the glass and good. Jackson Parks with two.
I think we're one of the younger teams this year. So it's been sort of a struggle, but I feel like we're on the right path going forward.
But we only got four returnees, so out of 19, 15 newcomers this year.
When we start losing, the practice really be hard. Coach is really on our ass hard then. We may run more and we mess up more, or he may sometimes, if he gets really mad, he's gonna kick us out, which we know we're playing like shit at that moment. And the bad just piles up, but we try not to stay in that spot for long. We try to keep our heads up and keep moving forward, but during those losses, things can get rough and everything just seems like it's bad at that point.
Yes, sir.
Jacob Dukes with the follow shot. Hicks takes it length of the floor, lays it up and scores. Shot is blocked, but the Eagles there to clean it up and score.
Okay, we're driving it, okay, and we don't have guys going to the glass, and where are we? We're hanging out here, watching the dadgum thing get the rebound, and then they go, okay? If you don't go to the glass, sprint back, sprint back. I'm sick of watching them shoot uncontested freaking layups, okay? I'm sick of it. Sprint back and get on defense, okay? That's a selfless act. It takes all of us to do it. When we sprint back, what do they end up doing? Throwing it right in your dead gum hands. Be physical on the glass and go.
Let's go.
Hey, one stop at a time. One stop at a time.
Got down there in the, I guess you could say trenches, in the trenches in the paint, and really just battle it out with the other team. And we just really showed our heart out there at that moment. We may have been smaller, but we showed our heart. And sometimes we seen towards the end, we started playing a little sloppy, but as long as we were hustling and going for everything, it was cool.
Big up there, fuck the
arms. Ladies and gentlemen, please direct your attention to the center court for a special presentation.
The half is really good. It's just defense. It's just defense. We can score on them anytime we want.
Yell louder.
Hey, halftime lead, okay? A halftime lead is a good thing to have, okay? A halftime lead is a good thing to have, but we've got to do a better job of going through prosperity, okay? We get a big lead, I think we let off the steam a little bit, okay? They drove by us, 13 got a couple good looks, okay? They start pushing the ball, we're taking ourselves out of place, okay? We gave them looks. We gave them looks, guys, okay? We gotta do a better job of that. Go win balls with two hands, all right? Now, at the same token, like, pick your heads up, because we got 20 minutes that if we win the second half, we win the game, okay? And bottom line, we gotta find a way together to get this thing up, okay? It's the bottom line, okay? Offensively, we did a pretty good job. A couple of careless turnovers, and man, I love the way we're pushing the ball. I love the way we're pushing the ball.
Relke gets it to the high post. Now Nix rises up for three. Got it. Grayson. Now ball reversed to the left. Cheater into the lane. Nice pass to the baseline for Cameron Relke. And Relke scores. The A-game is scoring. Left side, Relke. Nice move on the baseline. Feeds it to the left side. Three ball out from behind. Eagles come up with it. Alt runs the two on two. To the left side. Step back three. Powell got it. Three. Grayson Nix. 17 to shoot. Nix takes it to the basket himself. Went by the defender and laid it in. It is 83-80. Basketball. Ball is in the corner. Baseline drive. Pass to the open shooter in the right corner. It is good for three. Baseline 20 on the shot clock. Into Nix. Three ball. Perfect on the set piece. Grayson got it back out to the right side. Relke drew a double team. No look pass to the baseline. Reverse layup, good. Jacob got it back. 10 to shoot. Takes down the left hand drive, working against Relke. Pass across the lane, comes to the right. Goodard for three, and he'll connect. No, that's a 2-point shot. Now, at the right wing, gets it into the lane, into the corner. Nix with the ball fake. Now he'll drive to the basket, put up a shot. It's good. Blocking foul. Count the basket, and Grayson Nix will have a chance for a one-shot bonus. So it's 92-90. Free throw is good by Grayson Nix. That makes it 92-91.
On a late shot clock right here, can we double this hard? Can we double the ball hard?
And the screen goes the other way off of it, takes it to the basket, misses the shot. Offensive rebound inside by Jackson Reddy, and he'll put it back and score. Don't have to get a three here. Relke gets into the corner to Grayson Nix. He fires it and hits the three. No, they're not going to do that. Driving to the basket is Strickland, and he gets tied up going to the basket.
The alternating possession goes to U of O. Cruz have picked up full court defensively. Relke with the ball, brings up the floor, guarded by Goodman. We have 20 seconds left. Relke has the play call from the bench. Guarding him, 15 to play. Relke ball handling at the circle. Starts right, has a double high post screen. Relke goes all the way to the basket, takes it up, lays it up, and scores! Eagles by two with 6 seconds. Kangaroos into the front court. Rennie for three from the right side. That's no good. Eagles have the rebound and the win! The Eagles of the University of the Ozarks, 96. The Kangaroos of Austin College, 94. What a game.
Now it starts to get what we got to really lock in, because now these games start to matter. Not saying the last one didn't matter, but it's conference now, so you know every game counts towards trying to get to the playoffs or not making it. And with a win like AC, I'm thinking it's going to give us some real good momentum going forward. Hopefully we can keep it going, start gelling more together since we're still a young team, and really just go out there, because the conference is full of tough teams. Tough teams that got great players, and any given night, anybody can go out there and win or lose.
You got some fans there most of the time, and just, I mean, going on the road, you know, you're traveling, you know, you're not sleeping in your own bed, you're not used to, you know, kind of your daily routine. So, I mean, it takes a lot to be able to go somewhere and pull out a win, and, you know, that's why if you can split a road trip 1-1, I mean, that's what most people shoot for. I mean, just getting out there with the win is pretty tough.
Move to 10-1 on the season, 6-0 in the American Southwest Conference, while Ozarks falls to 1-8 and 0-5. Ozarks will remain in Abilene to take on McMurray on Saturday.
At the break, it's pretty much a new season. We kind of starting over from scratch almost, even though we wasn't going for that long. A week off of any professional sport or any sport you play is just kind of hard coming back. Like, we got to get back in our mindset that it's time to get back to work. So the way that we handle things, we might two practices a day. It's just us on campus, nobody else. So we got no classes. So weights, two practices a day, we eat together. Like, it's kind of just a time where we can all bond too. Cause like I said, nobody else on campus. So coming back, you just got to get back in.
I ain't been reading golf all my life, but I'm about to shit like I'm Tiger Woods.
Back
in the 5 feet.
You probably knew the
A,
but
no, I just
sat here all day,
Mike. Ain't no sunshine when it rains. When it rains, it pours.
Zuri, I see you. What up?
Ain't no sunshine when it rains. When it rains, it pours. That don't rain, but the sun won't shine anymore.
Back to count my G, back to grin my T, back to have a hoes in my fleet. Yeah, we hustling the dog anyway. We hustle to replace all the dog time we face. I done had plenty hard days, I done had plenty hard ache. I've been outside hugging trees, trying to find some peace, trying to find time for me to release. I've been trying to find time for me. And when it rain, umbrella my shelter to a sign for the sun to shine on me. On me. Any condition, nigga, rains, lead the snow.
That would have been too funny.
Knock some sense in this motherfucker.
Shit, maybe he would have got right.
He didn't get right.
Hey, y'all got me to get a headache for right here to have 25.
Stop.
It woke his ass up.
Yeah, anyway, crazy about
it. It woke his ass up. Huh? I was giving you them bitches in gift bags when you laid them hoes up.
This guy's different.
One right here, one right here, okay? One possession at a time, we're gonna get right back into it, okay? Let's refocus our efforts right here, okay? Gotta do it on the defensive side, don't we? Gotta do it on the defensive side. 14 points in 4 minutes is unacceptable, okay? Not good enough, not good enough. Physical blockouts,
thank you.
Sprint back on deep. We've had some good looks offensively, but what does all of our looks mean? All the looks are individualized, right? Okay? Make great passes. We don't have to get a shot off the first one or two. Into it, man. Let's go.
I got you, bro. I ain't gonna look at the camera no more.
Hey, man. That's what I'm talking about. That's the way to fight back, bro.
Hey, that shit was pretty, man. Wasn't it?
Hell yeah. That's the way to fight back.
Hey, I'm letting one shoot the ball, bro.
Me too.
I'm sorry. I'm not about to get up there and guard. I'm not.
Ray, you're saving him, bro.
With a hand out there.
All you got to do is just stun him.
Somebody know they got other
players. Because he wants to pull the first kick.
He's here. He's not here. He there. They're not holding us, bro.
Some instances where it's blatant obvious that so-and-so missed something. That's when we have to be stronger as a group. Okay, that's when we have to pick our teammates up. That's when, as on a bench, that we have to be those energy givers, right? Tell me if I'm wrong, but when they made a run, we as a group had a lull energy-wise, didn't we? Didn't we? Okay, and that's why it's so important that no matter what you are, no matter what your role is, okay, that we find a way to be energy givers. That we try to find a way to raise the group. And the only way to do that is if the guys on the floor respect the fact that, hey, these guys on the bench doing it, we've got to raise our game too. We've got to raise our game too. Okay, and it mainly energy-wise togetherness. Right, it's real easy to talk to your teammates when we just hit two or three threes in a row, or we just got a couple big stops, okay? It's hard when you're the one who fucked up, right? It's hard to do that, okay? But the best teams, even the good teams, they figure out a way when those lulls happen that they pick each other up. They hold each other accountable, but they pick each other up so that we can bounce back. Because what just happened is not nearly as important as what's about to happen. Right, that next play has got to be us together and giving our all. Okay, so we got to find a way to be better. It wasn't terrible, right? It's not like I'm beating my head against the wall because of who you were, but that we did have another role tonight. Okay, we did have another role. We got to raise ourselves out of that. Okay, I think that the competitiveness and after 9 days off, 2 weeks off from a game, our execution and the way that we took care of the ball was pretty darn good. Okay, it wasn't great, but it was pretty darn good. Okay, so we'll get better this week. Belhaven's coming in Thursday. We got to go with that win. Okay?
Basketball, you think all the fans and all the cheerleaders, but when you're playing with nobody out there, it's like a practice almost. Like, you kind of got to bring your own energy. It's quiet when you score. Ain't nobody clapping for you, like, other than your teammates, of course. But it's just a different mindset. You got to, like, hey, like, even though nobody here, like, I'm still going to do what I do, like, for the cameras, for whatever, so. That's the biggest part.
I'm an actual shooter.
What? Boy, you should like 28 from the three.
Boy, no.
You said just break the camera. Okay, my boy.
Hell, no. I ain't never get below 20.
Hell, no. Hey, yeah, you got the record.
Fuck.
Hey, you got the record. Hey, you got the record.
Yeah, that's terrible.
That is special.
That bitch is like 2.4.
They got almost you 40% next to you. Like, what if you look at it?
Damn,
this is what we see. Okay? This is what we see. Okay? Guard the crap out. Get stuck, baby. Finish play.
Hallelujah.
come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and give us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not to temptation, but deliver us from evil. For God is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever and ever. Amen.
Here we go, baby. Here we go, baby.
Hey, coming out to kill. Effort on three. 1, 2, 3. Yes, sir.
See, even on my birthday, I'm a little murder. I got the veins, I'm on the veins, I got the veins, I'm on the veins, I'm about the veins, I'm on the veins. I got the veins, I'm popping to like I got me a vein.
Great work defensively, great work defensively, guys. Please, every time we've got guys open, do not take contested shots. We don't have to take contested shots to be successful, okay? We work that ball around. They're too aggressive out there. One little shot fake, and where are they going? Slide five, okay? Then it's one or two dribbles in the paint. Easy guy. You see a secondary defender, you've got a teammate open, and it has to be delivered.
To warm-ups, okay, we've got to have that certain edge to ourselves, okay? And it's not a turn-on thing, right? It's not like when we leave the door, we turn it on. We've got to start thinking right now, okay? Because if we come out there lackadaisical, okay, if we come out there like everything's fine and dandy, okay, we're going to allow them to take the first punch. I love where we were offensively, okay? We shared the ball, 11 assists in one half of basketball is great, okay? And we can continue to do that. We can continue to do that. No early shots unless it's a wide open shot or right at the rim. Okay? Let's convert some stuff. Win those 50-50 balls. Win the ball off the glass. Run like crazy. If we don't have anything, share the basketball. Get something with our offense. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Put down the mind. Put down the mind by doing the little things great. Put down the mind by doing the little things great. And there's going to be a time. There's going to be a time in the second half. Well, we're going to come out of a timeout, and I'm going to yell, look at each one of you guys, and say, it's time to step on their throat, okay? The time is not right now. The time is to put down, but there will be a time, and that's when you end it right there.
Yeah.
right now. Guys, get it! Come on now! We break that thing, what's our first play?
Run!
Get us organized! Somebody talk out there! Gotta have good shots! Every shot's gotta be a good shot! Gotta defend with purpose! Come on now! One position at a time, and we gotta lock in right here! Lock in right here! Who's dragging the ball out? Okay? You gotta run the baseline. Dan, you gotta work to get open. If he's not open, we gotta have a multiple option. We're playing as individuals right now. Come on now. One possession right here. Let's go. Okay? Stop school stuff. Stop school stuff. Come on now. Let's go.
Let's go. Get it. Come on.
Two guys. One, two, three.
All right. All right.
We gotta use this as a huge learning point here. You know, I don't know about you guys, like they hit a couple shots, but you know what just glares at me is how I feel like we threw it to their hands too often and they just laid it up, right? I mean, it says in there that they have 16 points off turnovers, and I think probably all 16 of those were them laying it up or dunking it, okay? And we've got to learn how to take care of the ball. Okay? I mean that type of pressure should not affect us the way that it did. Okay? And you know, for me, like I'm in the mindset where I've got to look myself in the mirror and say I did not prepare you guys well enough yesterday to handle that pressure. Okay, that's on me. That's on me for not doing that. Okay. But as a group, we've got to look each other in the mirror, look ourselves in our eyes and say, you know, we didn't do a good enough job, okay, as a group. You know, when we broke it and we got some opportunities, you know, we had some good success. But, you know, what I'm thinking of is, man, my first instinct is, okay, we inbounded the ball and where were our eyes as soon as we caught the ball? Right back to the inbounder, wasn't it? That's what it seemed like to me. Is that as soon as we caught it, we were thinking about how do I get it back to the inbounder? And you know, that's on me. But we've got to make those adjustments in the game. I don't think we met the ball well enough today. I think, you know, looking back on it, like I think we were a tough freaking team, like a tough team physically, right? Because 15, we held them to half their offensive rebounds today. Half their offensive rebounds. That's something to be proud of. Okay, a big athletic group like that, something to be proud of. But on the flip side of that, there was probably 10 shots that were right at the rim that they didn't even get a chance to offensive rebound, right? That we didn't do a good enough job defensively or taking care of the ball, and they just laid it up. Dear Holy Father, thank you for allowing us to play. Thank you for allowing us to compete at a high level. Help us to learn from the bumps that we took today. Help us to grow as a group, to have faith in you, to be kind and gracious, and to have mercy on people even if we don't like them. Thank you for all of our great blessings. Be with those not as fortunate as we are. In God's holy name we say, amen.
Amen.
Here we go. Come on.
Seven on three, Eagles on six. 1, 2, 3.
Seven.
4, 5, 6.
Eagles.
I've been sidelined this year with an injury, and I've been trying to think of the bright side about what God has in store and think of the main reason why he wanted me to sit down. Maybe he wants me to see other parts of the game and other ways that I can help out the team, but it's been a struggle sitting out with my injuries. And I've also had to step away from the bench and be one of those first front row sitters in the crowd because I'm on academic probation. And although it is a wake-up call for me, telling me to get on my things and get on my shit, basically, get on everything under control, it also adds a sort of flair or just part of the game that I love because I'm a really vocal and energetic player. And on the bench, I can't yell or say certain stuff because I might get the team a tick. Whereas if I'm front row, they can't do anything to me on the crowd because the crowd says and yells things all the time. So I have more just reign to say things and talk to my players and do whatever.
I mean, it can be going better, of course, but I think it's time for us to lock in. Like, we already won a couple of games. We know what it do. it's getting to the point of the season where we're playing everybody twice, so we're gonna have their scouting reports. We know exactly what they do. We know how to beat them. We know if we lost to them, we know what to do to beat them for the next time. So it's getting to that point, but it's kind of getting clutch time too, so we definitely got to sit down and lock it.
Pressure, but take the responsibility. Take the responsibility. Let's go get this thing, okay? We do it on the defensive side, and we do it with rebounding, okay? Take care of the rock, and the rest will take care of it play itself. On a battle swim, when the storm comes, I'm put on a show. Make it flash, you know I got it. The world is mistaken, it's a big band. I'm feeling like a woman band. I'm feeling like they were a band. And the temptations, I'm setting the vibe. I'm changing the elements, coming in.
Filthy out the mud, I'm always on the go. I say what's on my mind, but flying on the low. To cause hell, this my devil fit. Smoking got me feeling heavenly. It's the rise of the underdog.
It'll be tough for Limbo. Is he passing that thing out? Not that never. Okay, if you're around him, don't put him in jail. Don't put him in jail and keep him off the glass. Okay? Come on now. Get an edge to yourself, Drake.
Yeah. cool, bro. We're cool.
It's on everyone.
It's on everybody.
It's on everybody, bro.
It's on everybody.
That was a collective loss.
Fuck! I'm gonna go get him. Damn.
I feel like they just took it. If we did a part by giving it to them a little bit, if they came in here and they took it. We gotta give them credit for hitting some shots in the second half, but 18 turnovers, 10 in the second half, that just doesn't get it done.
Right now, I'm absolutely heated because I don't feel like I did my job to get you guys ready to play. To get you guys to play at a high level against a really good team. I think we had a lot of moments where we were a soft group. Where we were just a soft group. Feeling sorry about ourselves. Not blocking out, getting hit, not called. I mean, they called like freaking 50 fouls. I want each of you guys to look up and look me in the eye here. We are good enough. We are good enough. And you've got to believe that. We are tough enough to get it done. And you gotta believe it, okay? We're good enough, we're tough enough, but it's gonna take everyone to believe it and go and take action. It's gotta be that way.
The standings right now are weird, and weirdly as it may seem, is as bad as we're playing right now, we still have a great shot at getting in the playoffs. You may have one or two powerhouse teams right now that are at the top two, but you got six other spots that are up for grabs for anybody with literally probably one game.
Coach,
he had one.
Am I out?
No, he's still in.
Oh, okay.
Third ball coming in.
Get in, jump stop.
Yeah, got a jump stop. Got a jump stop. Play off two. Okay. Guys, okay. No more 50-50 passes. Heart attack, you know, we're going back and forth. Yeah. I love our effort offensively, defensively, right? We're getting tipped, win that ball, and then go off two and get some good stuff.
Minor just came in.
Tigers win 82-55.
You looked at me, I looked at you.
Dropping these two games, man, it's just bad because I feel like we really could have beat those. Said those were some of the bottom ranked teams, and we just wasn't playing good. They definitely aren't good enough to beat us at all. And I'm really upset about that because now we got to come into this week with more pressure on our back and play against two of the teams that are actually the powerhouses. And although I know we can beat them as well, it just makes things harder and putting more pressure on your back. It's just like, I don't know, it's less room for mistake. And I don't know. With it being at home, no, everything like this, I love the pressure. I just wish I could go out there because right now it's eating me alive just sitting from the side, not being able to help them. It's always by your side.
Everywhere. It's kind of like I don't even want to think about it right now. Really, I'm just really kind of focused on the game, not even knowing it's my last one. But I think it's always a thought in the back of my mind. It's probably going to make me play harder, but it got me thinking about all the times we put in the gym, staying up late, waking up early, working out, running miles. So I'm just going to put all that into this last game, potentially last game we're going to have. And, you know, make it not my last game. I want to play some more. I don't want this to be my last game. So those are feelings I got coming into it. But again, it's kind of just another game. You gotta find what works and stick to it, and hopefully you can get the dub, so it won't be my last game.
Simple play.
Hey, that's the way to f-ing fight, guys. Yes, sir. Anyway, yes, sir. Anyway, 20 more minutes of all we got.
Yes, sir.
20 more minutes. I promise you one thing. You're going to get my best effort. You're going to get my damn best effort right here.
Yes, sir.
Hell yeah. You got me, coach.
We got to find a way to continue this season. Like, we don't want February 19th to be our last game. Like, we don't want it to be the last time I get out there, especially me being a senior, get out there and play and everything. So we got to find a way to win so we can keep this train rolling pretty much.
Okay. Any other conversation that I need to know about? Mm-hmm. Any ideas? Okay, we're good to go?
Yes,
good
sir.
To go? Yes, 20 minutes of hell right here. 20 minutes of hell. Let's go. Come on, fellas.
You gotta show them all.
Fight together. 1, 2, 3. Fight together.
Right away after the make.
Hold it right here. AK3, this AK5 is the moment right here.
know what time. I don't know what time you got. Okay, you're not gonna be a, you're not gonna be able to 0.6, okay? You can catch and shoot. Okay, no dribbles. Okay? Here we go, here we go, here we go, together. 1, 2, 3, together.
Oh shit, Ray.
Get a real
one. Yes, sir. Grayson coming off on the other side for the three on the left side.
So you're gonna catch that on like throw a baseline?
No, I wasn't supposed to catch.
Oh, you just cut and you threw that bitch?
So I was supposed to cut, but I was supposed to just go out.
Oh,
and then Grayson's coming around for the loop for the three on the left side.
Damn.
I swear to God. I didn't even want to tie the game.
I'm about to throw him on the power line up there, so every time y'all go to practice, y'all see it, y'all.
Catch me at the showtime.